Investment opportunities in agricultural trade tackled by Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. and separate meetings on the sidelines of the ASEAN Summit in Cambodia. But as Joyce Valancho tells us, Marcos's desire to achieve consensus on managing disputes in the South China Sea might face the same obstacle that cropped up in Cambodia's hosting of the summit in 2012.
It was a jam-packed first day for Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr.'s visit to Cambodia for the summits of the Association of Southeast Asian Nations, or ASEAN. He began the day by inviting Cambodian businessmen to invest in the Philippines. Marcos said his government has implemented policy changes on public-private partnership and government-to-government deals. According to the Office of the Press Secretary, there has been an agreement to cooperate on various areas such as rice importation, low-cost housing, even hiring of more Filipino nurses in Cambodia, among others. Marcos also joined other ASEAN leaders in a meeting with the King of Cambodia, Norodom Sihamoni. Meanwhile, Marcos hopes to raise during the meetings the South China Sea issue and the need to finalize a code of conduct that nations will follow in resolving conflicts in the contested waters. But in 2012, during Cambodia's previous hosting of the ASEAN, the member states failed to reach an agreement on how to deal with the South China Sea issue amid speculations that Cambodia, being an ally of China, blocked any discussion on the territorial dispute. Marcos also hopes to speak with Chinese President Xi Jinping, but the Philippine Department of Foreign Affairs said the Chinese leader won't be attending the ASEAN summit and only Chinese Prime Minister Li Qiang will be present. Marcos also held a bilateral meeting with the Prime Minister of Vietnam, who congratulated the Philippines for its COVID-19 response and for being one of the countries that has the highest GDP growth in the ASEAN region. The two leaders agreed to boost ties in security, trade, and agriculture, especially that the Philippines considers Vietnam as an important partner in ensuring food security. Marcos noted that 90% of our rice imports come from Vietnam. In the foreign minister's bilateral meeting attended by DFA Secretary Enrique Manalo, the Philippines and Cambodia agreed to expedite the drafting of an agreement to avoid double taxation on goods exchanged by the two nations. Cambodian Deputy Prime Minister Prak Sokhon also encouraged the Philippines to import more rice from them. The ministers also discussed adding more direct flights between Philippines and Cambodia. Before the day ended, Marcos met with members of the ASEAN Business Advisory Council, where he encouraged the members to support the micro, small, and medium enterprises. Joyce Balancho, ABS-CBN News, Cambodia.
U.S. President Joe Biden to meet with his Chinese counterpart Xi Jinping on November 14 on the sidelines of the G20 summit in Bali, Indonesia. The White House says the leaders will discuss efforts to deepen lines of communication as well as how to work together on common interests. The two countries have a massive investment and trade relationship, but are also challenging each other's military and diplomatic influence. They also face a potential flashpoint over the South Pearl Island of Taiwan, and the Chinese Foreign Ministry says Beijing attaches great importance to the proposed meeting and urges the U.S. to meet China halfway. A U.S. administration official says Biden hopes to limit the deterioration of ties with China when he meets with Xi, but will also be honest about U.S. concerns. China's new top leaders reinforced the need to stick with the country's contentious zero-COVID policy. In its first meeting since being formed last month, the Politburo Standing Committee said China's epidemic prevention measures must not be relaxed. New case numbers are at their highest since April, and the aggressive response has been causing disruptions for residents and businesses and weighing on financial markets. Chinese share prices soared last week on hopes that China would begin easing COVID curbs. But Beijing continues to reiterate its signature policy that authorities argue save lives. Many now believe China is unlikely to begin easing until March at the earliest.